Now, chapter 1, computer hardware components. Unit 1, so two units are there. Unit 1, components of a computer system. Now, whenever we use the term computer system, it means that other than the four important parts, that is mouse, keyboard, monitor and CPU, what other extra devices which are attached with the computer, we'll see the use, functions and applications of it. Now first we'll define the term computer system. A computer is an electronic data processing machine which accepts data and instruction through an input device. It has the ability to process the data into meaningful information in the desired form. All of you see the drawing or the figure given here of a computer system. So other than four important things, so extra what we have is a printer, a speaker. Other than that, we can have like extra devices which are not given in the diagram, like we can have a modem, then a web camera, joystick, extra devices can be added. Now the now we'll see the primary functions of a computer system. Now, so in the book they have given four primary functions. It holds all the components of a computer together and protects the sensitive electronic parts from the outside elements. It takes care of all the devices. It uses a common storage for all the parts of a computer. So normally it is the hard disk. It executes user-written or user-defined programs. So whatever it is, the programs which are given here are executed. Fourth point, it performs the user-designated data manipulation, including arithmetic and logical operations. So any kind of functions are being taken care. Now, these two very common terms, that is hardware and software. Now, the definition of hardware is underlined. So hardware is the term given to the machinery itself and the various components and equipments of a computer system. So here these examples are given here. So all this mouse, monitor, keyboard, speaker, all comes under as an example of hardware. Next term is coming as a software. Now software refers to the set of computer programs, procedures and associated documents that describes how the programs are to be executed. So here whenever we use the term as a software, means like MS Word, MS Excel, Windows, those are the examples of software. The examples or the icons are given here. Now whenever we come to this relationship between hardware and software, I cannot say that hardware is more important than software or software is more important than hardware. In a computer system, both hardware and software have to work efficiently, coordinately for the proper functioning of the computer system. Thus, that last line, thus hardware and software are complementary to each other. And here you see one drawing given here. So where we see the hardware at the bottom, operating system, application software, and the top, that is the user. So all these different labels are interconnected with each other. The difference between hardware and software, five differences are given, which are very very important. Now we'll come to the types of softwares. So first is the system software. System software means, so if you go first, if you know the examples like Windows, Android, Linux, means it is a set of one or more programs designed to control the operation of a computer system. So the overall function of the computer system is being taken care, both hardware and software. Application software refers to like MS Word, MS Excel, which are purely designed for the user. So user has to take the help of it to perform the different jobs. Now we'll see the next part. The most important part is the CPU, we say as the brain of the computer or the main processing unit. So it is the main component of a computer system that is integrated with the microprocessor and the memory unit. Now if you see the drawing given here, so CPU, so this CPU, this it will be more clear with the help of this diagram. Now in a CPU there are three parts are there: ALU, primary memory, control unit, input device, output device, secondary memory. Now so here the user will give the inputs with the help of mouse or keyboard. Different components are there which will take care, will see the output. Part of it will be stored in the secondary memory, it may be hard disk or pen drive, whatever it is. Now we'll see the function of each of these components. First one is arithmetic and logic unit. So it will perform the any kind of operations like arithmetic, addition, subtraction, operations. Next as the control unit. Control unit means it will take care of whatever the peripheral devices which are attached with the computer will be taken care. So system, it retrieves the data and instructions from the memory and sends the command to various parts of the computer system. Next is coming as the memory unit. Now this memory unit means it is the place where the data and instructions are entered in the computer system through the input units, maybe mouse or keyboard, and are to be stored. Now for this stored, it may be the hard disk or either it may be a RAM or a ROM. So it provides a space for storing data, instruction, intermediate results and the final result. Now the main functions of the CPU are: it stores the data and instructions in the memory which can be accessed for processing. It processes the data to give the meaningful results. It controls each and every operation of the computer peripherals. Next topic is coming as the computer memory. Now memory is the basic unit of a computer where it can store data and instruction for the future reference. Now this whole memory, it is divided into two types: primary memory, secondary memory. Primary memory refers to RAM and ROM. Secondary memory refers to optical disks, hard drive, flash drive or the pen drive. Now we'll see all these things more in detail, starting with primary memory. Now whenever we say as a primary memory, it always refers to RAM and ROM. Now so first we'll define what is primary memory. Primary memory is the main memory which is the basic unit of the computer. It has a faster access time, smaller storage capacity with respect to secondary memory of the system. So this memory is accessed directly by the CPU. Now here in this primary memory, various informations are stored which are helpful for its running. Now first we'll see what is RAM. RAM full form is random access memory. The RAM helps in the loading of the operating system or in booting. The user can access the RAM for various kinds of uses. It is smaller in size. Now in the market, various types of RAMs with different capacities are available. In your computer you can remove, so this RAM is removable. You can remove this RAM and place a RAM of higher capacity. Next is coming as the ROM. ROM, read-only memory. So ROM, it is a chip, ROM chip, which is present on the motherboard, which is mainly helps in the various functions of the operating system. The program stores are not erasable, it is non-volatile in nature and the user cannot access it. Now this, the difference between RAM and ROM are given here, which are very very important. Next is coming as secondary memory, so which is very very popular. Secondary memory or the secondary storage are the units where the data or informations are stored for future reference. So this, all the secondary memory, the user has a direct access, like hard disk, magnetic tape, floppy disk, magnetic drum, optical disk, it may be CD or DVD or the pen drive. Now out of all these six devices, nowadays only hard disk, optical disk, pen drive, these three are only used, others have become backdated. Now here the difference between primary and secondary memory is given, which is very important from the exam point of view. Next we'll see about the disk drives one by one. So the disk drives, it is a peripheral device used for the storage and the retrieve of information of the computer. It includes floppy disk drive, optical drives, and it also includes optical media such as CDs or DVDs. Now we'll see one by one. First is the compact disc, which is quite popular for storing the audios, videos and text. So its diameter is 120 mm and it can store any information, audio, video, up to 80 minutes. And here one term is written as 52x, which represents its speed, and its capacity is 700 MB. In the market normally we get this CDR, which is quite easily being used. It is available in the market for 9 rupees or 10 rupees, where the data can be stored repeatedly and delete option is not available. Next is coming as CDRW, which is rewritable, which is available in the market for 30 to 40 rupees, where the delete option is possible. Next is coming as the DVD. So DVD stands for digital versatile disk, whose storage capacity is 4.7 GB. Now the DVDs, so the DVDs have become more popular and CDs are replaced by DVDs. So the DVD has to be placed in the DVD drive to access it. Now the various types of different types of DVDs are available in the market. Next is coming as power supply or SMPS. This SMPS, it is the small box which all of you will find at the back of your CPU, where the black wire directly from the wall or from the electricity board is directly connected. So it acts like an amplifier, where the 240 volt is lowered to 5 volt or 6 volt for various devices to operate. Next coming as the motherboard. So this motherboard, it is placed inside the CPU box. Please have a look at it properly. So here inside this only, so there are various slots are there. So this is the slot where the RAM is present. We can place it. And this motherboard is a circuit board where various components are present. Next is coming as the port. So port are the connecting nodes to interface of the peripheral devices with the processor, and it acts as a bridge between the external device and the CPU. Now these ports are classified into various types. First we have the serial port. The serial port is used to supply data serially, bit by bit. It is a 8-bit pattern, or 8 bits of data is transferred at a time, and mostly it is present in the devices like mouse and modem. Next is coming as the parallel port, having 24 pins female connector, and is capable of transmitting 8-bit signals at a time. Examples like CD writer, scanner, printers or the hard disks. Next, the most popular one is the USB port or universal serial bus. Now all the digital devices, any kind of digital devices are connected with the USB port, like printer, plotter, mouses, joystick, pen drive, digital cameras or the smartphones, camcorder. Any devices having the USB port can be easily connected with the computer. Now the last we are coming to as the modem. Now in order to access internet from your smartphone or a desktop or a laptop, The modem is compulsory. Without modem, I cannot access the internet. So the main function of a modem is it modulates or demodulates the digital signals, or in simple words, it converts analog signals to digital signals and vice versa. Now these modems are available in three types. Now first is coming as the internal modem. Now this internal modem is normally placed inside your smartphone. It is a small chip present in your smartphone or the motherboard, or in your laptop's motherboard it is present. The external modem, which looks like this, normally it is black in color, and you will find it in the cyber cafe or in your house. It is kept in one place. Next is coming as the USB modem. Now this USB modem, it looks like this, similar to your pen drive, and inside this you have to connect the SIM has to be connected, and you have to make some payments in order to access it, and it has to be connected at the back of your CPU in any of the USB port. Now these are the various ways we can connect the modem, and all of them have the common function to access the internet. So we come to the end of this chapter. At the back, see objective type questions answers are there. Objective type, subjective, then long answer questions. Make sure all of you write in your computer copies. It will be corrected once the school reopens. Thank you.